In this video, we're taking a look at working with the 3D file format FBX in Storyboard. FBX from Autodesk is a file format that's been widely adopted as an industry standard. It has the ability to include animations with the model file, in addition to containing textures, lighting, and other properties that come as part of a 3D model. So let's start off by taking a look at an FBX model that's been given to me by one of our modelers. I can open this up with FBX Review, which is a free program provided by Autodesk. So here we are in a 3D space, and if I zoom out, we can see that what we're looking at is an automotive cluster design. I've got a speedometer and tachometer, and if I go up to the top right corner, there's a dropdown that lists all of the animations that are included with this model file. And these are going to be able to move this content around as needed in our UI. The animation called Dials Out is going to swing the speedometer and tachometer away, and this will free up some more space in the center of the UI to make more room for a navigation system or other information like weather or an ADAS system. There's another animation that brings dials back in, and this third animation shows the pointer or needles in motion as well. So everything we're looking at in here was created in 3D Studio Max. The aim is to have the 3D modelers create content in tools that they want to use and are comfortable in, and then be able to bring those into Storyboard. Storyboard is able to use 3D in conjunction with 2D. If I take a look at our Photoshop file, we're looking at the UI that's composed of other elements. There's your gas gauge, warning lights, the odometer. It's all part of a comprehensive interface, and we're going to bring all of this together in Storyboard. We can see in Photoshop how the speedometer and tachometer are going to fit in this space. So now let's take a look at how this is done. If I move over to Storyboard, we're going to create a new project using the Photoshop import feature. So here I'm going to browse to the Photoshop file that we were just looking at for the cluster design. So here's democluster.psd. When I select it and finish, it imports the project into our workspace. So now we have this new project. If I take a look in the image directory, all of the images from our Photoshop file have been brought in. If we take a look at the UI, it's the same as while we were in Photoshop. And then all of the naming conventions and organization that was done ahead of time in Photoshop have been maintained in Storyboard. So on the top layer, I have a control called Replace with 3D. This is where I'm going to add the cluster. So I'm going to add a new render extension for a 3D model. So over here, I'll click Add, select 3D model, and now this is going to be where we're going to point at that FBX file. I don't need this image render extension anymore as a placeholder, so I can get rid of that. And for model, I'll browse to either an OBJ or FBX file. Since we don't have any in the project yet, we're going to need to import one. So now I'll browse into our project directory, and there are the demo dials that we looked at the beginning of this video. I'll hit open, and we're going to bring it into the demo cluster project. So when I hit finish, I have our demo dials that we can select. But if you look at the file extension, it's an SSG file. The FBX file format isn't as well suited for embedded devices, so Storyboard converts the file to SSG, which is optimized for an embedded environment. SSG is a Storyboard scene graph file format. It includes all of the same animation attributes, all of the same structural elements from the FBX file, but packages it in a way that we can leverage these resources in an embedded system. So when I select this to bring it in, the first thing is with 3D elements, we need to be able to position our content in the scene. So this dialog box, do you want to resize the model to fit the control, is a best guess on resizing the content and setting the camera to be able to see the 3D dials that we bring in. I'm going to first adjust the positioning for the camera and set camera Z to 150, and then I'm going to increase the values for the near clipping plane and far clipping plane. Now I've got our automotive UI in place. We have our 2D content and 3D FBX elements in the same space, so now let's take a quick look with the simulator. If I save and launch the simulator, we can see everything in Storyboard Engine, and it looks good. So now let's add those animations we saw in FBX Review to our project. In the Properties view, if we take a look at our render extension for the 3D model, there's a list of properties for the camera and more attributes that can be set on the model, as well as the lighting. But Storyboard is also able to grab the animations that were done outside of Storyboard. When I click Import Animation, in the dialog box that appears, I can see the animations that we were looking at in FBX Review, and I'm going to select all of these animations and add them to our project. If I open up the Animation Timeline tab, we can see our animations. The frame rate they were created in will be the same frame rate in Storyboard. So when I open this up, we can see all the variables being called, and if I want to take a look in the animation preview, I can scrub through to see these dials in motion. These animations aren't fixed either. They can be refined and edited within Storyboard. If I look inside the variables view, here's a list of all the different variables that have been added to this project but were defined in Studio Max. These variables have been labeled to indicate which nodes from what object are being called. Now I want to test out these animations to see how they look in the UI. So first, I'm going to go to the application level and add an action that says, when the application starts, that's going to be our trigger event. We want it to trigger an animation, and it's going to move the dials out. And then I'm going to add another action that says, when the dial's done moving out, let's trigger another animation that is going to move the needles. So the needles will go up and down, and then when that's done, we'll make our last action be, when the needles are done animating, we'll trigger the animation to move the dials back in where they started from. This way, we'll see everything in sequence. So I'm going to simulate the project and save everything, and now we'll see our dials move out, the needles move up and down, and then the dials should slide back in, which it does. So now we've seen how to add 3D content to a project and import animations that come with an FBX file. Now let's take a quick look at a sample project that's primarily built around 3D content. Here's an FBX file for a model house that's going to be the main part of a home automation system. There are multiple rooms and a lot of opportunities to add animations that can tie into this application. I'm going to open up the IoT sample, and if I take a look at the animation timeline, I've got a full list of different animations. We can use animations to move in and around this home automation system. This animation involves making changes with the camera, whereas another animation may focus on changing the model and the camera. There's a lot of control that's given to the user to plan and execute great applications. Being able to combine workflows from external programs that can be brought forward into Storyboard makes it easier for users to create and refine their work. In the same way that Storyboard encourages graphic designers to work with the tools they feel comfortable working in, the same goes for 3D modelers, and by providing support for the FBX file format, Storyboard gives modelers the ability to create without restriction and take their work to the next level. Come and see why people are using Storyboard for their embedded UI applications. Try out the Storyboard Suite 30-day trial for free at cranksoftware.com.